There are two things I remember from ninth grade physics. The first is that Crest isn't just a toothpaste brand. It's also the highest point on a wave. The second is the theory of quantum mechanics. Now, before anyone gasps in awe, no, I'm not going to be delivering a speech on quantum mechanics because I do not have the knowledge. I remember sitting in that physics classroom one hot day after lunch. As luck may have it, this was the day we would encounter quantum mechanics for the very first time. The lights were dimmed, and this model was projected in front of the room. This model illustrates how an electron can exist everywhere and nowhere at the same time. I learned that scientists rely on a specific random point that could be here, here, or here. This was quite an overwhelming concept, because how could something be there and not be there at the same time? For ninth grade Laura, this was all too much. For her, there was always just one answer, right or wrong. In this case, there was no right or wrong. There was just a maybe. Maybe if the scientists had looked for the electron before lunch, they would have found it somewhere else. I was not satisfied with maybe, so I left that physics classroom quite frustrated that scientists couldn't decide where an electron should or shouldn't be. Still, the idea lingered, until one day during Cal class, we were looking at theorems and proofs. The most well-known theorem for high schoolers is the Pythagorean theorem. Although very few high schoolers question the validity of this theorem, there are several proofs. I can stand here and show you example after example of a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared, all leading me to the correct answers. But if I show you just one example where this doesn't hold true, you will walk away remembering just that. We can agree that the tiny possibility that this theorem doesn't hold true stands out more than the greater possibility that it does. This isn't something new. When we face challenges, we tend to magnify extreme outcomes regardless of however many possibilities there are. In that physics classroom, I hadn't thought much about the area between there or not there, good or bad, pessimistic and optimistic. Unlike scientists, we tend to rely on a specific random point without taking into consideration all the other possible outcomes there are. I think the scientists were onto something. They had found a way to map and analyze all the possible points before they even went looking for it. To me, that sounds like a great way to problem solve. We can map out our own field of probabilities to look at the positive, neutral, and negative outcomes that come from the challenges we face. I'm not being pessimistic for judging that the good doesn't always outweigh the bad in all situations. With this map, we're prepared. Now, there's a fine line between being prepared for the worst and overthinking the worst. There are just possibilities and ways to deal with these outcomes. Skydivers jump with two parachutes in the unlikely event that one falls off or it doesn't open. We wear seatbelts even though we never want to be put in the position where they have to save our lives. These safety measures don't make us pessimistic. We just recognize that there are multiple outcomes and we prepare accordingly. This is how we can problem solve challenges. Let's say you were stranded out at sea. A big wave comes over you, so you start to panic. If we map out this challenge, we can see that there is a chance of drowning. There's also a chance that the wave will pass. There's a chance that a shark will get to you before the wave does. There's even a chance a dolphin will come to your rescue. There's actually a greater chance that the dolphin will get to you before the shark does. That's a misconception. You're also far more likely to get killed by a cow, but that's besides the point. Your ability to recognize all these possibilities is what makes the difference. A known law of quantum mechanics is that no measurement is certain and probability reigns supreme in the subatomic world. This applies to us too. Relying on one point or one possibility isn't accurate in picturing the world that surrounds us. It is all possibilities and all outcomes that create a broader, more accurate picture. Now, what if you've mapped out your field of probability? How can you avoid being overwhelmed by all the possibilities and how can you make choices? Think of it like a game of chess. You can play it all out in your head and it'll hurt a little less if you can predict the checkmate. When you're playing chess, you can only make decisions based on what's in front of you. This is the same. There's no point in focusing on the unknown or the outliers. The next time you're facing a challenge, Take a minute to recognize all the possible outcomes and don't let one extreme dim the rest. At the end of the day, the only thing you're in control of is your reaction and preparedness. The rest just depends on which random outcome you find when looking at your own field of probability. Thank you.